You know that feeling when you look at your investment statement and think, is that final number telling me the whole story? Well, today, we're going to cut right through all that noise. We're going to take a pretty common financial situation and figure out what the real return on investment is, step by step. All right, so here's the puzzle for today. Imagine you've been saving $200 a month for 3 years, and you end up with a little over $8,500. Sounds pretty good, right? But here's the catch. There's a 10% bonus baked right into that number. So the real question is, how well did your money actually perform all by itself? So where do we even begin? Well, the first thing we have to do is work backwards. To get to the true return, we've got to strip away that bonus and find out what our money earned on its own. It's time to peel back the layers. This is our starting point, $8,500.32. But remember, this number is a little inflated. And here's why. That final number you see, it includes that 10% bonus. So what you're really looking at is 110% of what your investment actually made. To figure out the real performance, we've got to get that bonus out of there. So how do we do that? It's actually some pretty simple math. Since that final number is 110%, we just have to divide it by 1.10. That takes us right back to the original 100% and leaves us with just our contributions and what they earned. And that gives us our real number, $7,727.56. In the world of finance, we call this the future value, or FV. This number, this is the key to solving the whole puzzle. Okay, so now that we have our true future value, we need the right tool for the job. And to find the interest rate that got us here, we're going to use a classic, super important financial formula. It's called the future value of an annuity. Now, that might sound a little intimidating, but an annuity is just a fancy word for a series of equal payments, you know, just like our $200 a month. This formula is the bridge that connects our payments, the number of months, and the interest rate to that final value we just figured out. So let's lay out all the clues to our mystery here. We know the future value, the FV, we know the monthly payment, or PMT, and we know the number of months. You see, the only piece of the puzzle that's missing is the monthly interest rate, which we'll just call I. That's our target. With all our variables laid out nice and neat, it's time for the main event. We are going to use that powerful future value formula to solve for our one unknown, I, that monthly interest rate. So here's the game plan. First, we plug all of our known values into the formula. Now, the tricky part is actually solving for I. Because it's mixed up in both a fraction and an exponent, you can't really isolate it with basic algebra. That's why in the real world, we let technology do the heavy lifting with a financial calculator or a spreadsheet. You just tell it what you know, and it spits out the answer. And after running those numbers through the calculator, this is what it gives us. The monthly interest rate that makes the whole equation work is 0.93%. We are so close, but we're not quite done yet. Okay. So we have our monthly rate, but let's be real, nobody talks about their investment returns in monthly terms. To make this number actually mean something, we have to convert it into an annual rate. This is the last and maybe most important step.
And to do that, we find what's called the effective annual rate. Now, we can't just multiply our monthly rate by 12, because that would ignore the magic of compounding, you know, where your interest starts earning its own interest. This formula takes all of that into account.
And when we run that final calculation, we get 11.7%. That is it. That is the true annual return on this investment. It's the real performance that was kind of hidden behind that bonus. We found our answer. Okay, so we've done all the math, but why does any of this actually matter? Well, this isn't just some abstract math problem. This is about having practical knowledge that you can use in your own financial life. This is why knowing this stuff is so powerful. When you can calculate the true return, you can compare different investments apples to apples. You can see if you're really on track to hit your goals, and you can spot how things like fees or bonuses are really affecting you. It's all about empowering you to make way smarter decisions with your money. So that leaves us with a challenge for you. We've just walked through one example, but this principle applies to everything. The next time you're looking at your own investment statement, I want you to look beyond that big final balance. Ask yourself, can I figure out what my true return is?